Today is Wednesday, November 12th, the 316th day of 2014.
And you're listening to This and That on the Wire. Good morning, Norman, Oklahoma. Welcome to This and That. I'm Keegan Bean. Along with me, as always, my co-host, partner in crime, the Goondog Millionaire himself, Jeremy Deere. This and That, we're on every Wednesday morning from 9 to 11 Central Standard Time, of course. Why? Because we live in the heart of America. That's right, Oklahoma. You can listen to us through a variety of different ways. We recommend you going on our station's website at wire.ou.edu. That again is wire.ou.edu. We also highly recommend you downloading the TuneIn radio app, or you can go on tunein.com. If you do either or, make sure in the search bar to search your student radio, and you will locate The Wire. That will be our station. So make sure to go and download that app or go online right now. You can also go on livestream.com/TheWireOU. You should also do us a favor, maybe go on our Facebook page, give us a little likey-like. We really would appreciate it.
I like the likes.
I like likes, too. That is facebook.com/TheWireOU. Dang, that's The Wires. I was doing so well, too.
Man, this was we were going to have the perfect game until that happened.
Facebook.com/thisandthatwire. That, again, is facebook.com/thisandthatwire. Not and, the letter N.
And make sure that you follow our individual Twitter accounts, which mine is at JIV3.
The number 3, not the word 3.
Yeah, JIV3. It's like Jive with a 3 instead of an E.
Mine's at Mina. So if you know my last name, it's just my last name. It's at MEENAGH. We have Thug Life in the booth today.
He's going to be joining us in our next segment.
And we will have awesome a guy. Special guest all the way from Kansas to talk to us a little
all
bit about music.
All the way from Canada.
Canada.
It's near Canada. Kansas.
We also like to say, if you're a musician in a band, you're a local artist, you got some kind of cool talent in the Oklahoma City Metro, and you're interested in being on our show, please let us know. You can hit us up. We are always looking for talented musicians to provide us insight on the local music scene, on the local art scene, on the local talent scene. And plus, Jeremy and I were big advocates of all those. So please let us know. Tell your friends. Keep on rocking.
Yeah, we like to spread the word about new and upcoming artists and music lovers and whatnot alike. We had Carlos and Jesse on. They actually had a online web show. So it's not just pertaining to music. It's pertaining to any arts.
We had a friend, Angel Burke, on, who's an aspiring actress. We've kind of strayed from the musicians, and we've made it to where it's art for everybody. But something important that's coming up next week is what we like to tell you is we at The Wire will be partaking in a Toys for Tots marathon all day November 20th and 21st at Hertz Donut on Campus Corner here in Norman. So if you have a chance to come by, all the members of The Wire will be working day and night. We'll be on the air 24/7, and we're going to be trying to get people to deliver toys to Hertz Donuts for underprivileged children.
Yeah, so come out and bring a toy, man, at Hertz Donuts. We'll be there. I'll be there early in the morning. I got an early morning shift.
And if you haven't had Hertz Donut yet, it's a 24/7 donut shop. So you can come by and get a donut if you're to endure the cold. And if you bring two toys, Jeremy and I can get a donut too.
Yeah, so make sure you guys. Hey, and you know what? Come by, say hi to me. I'll see if I can't get you on the air and make you part of This and That on location.
Yeah, so please, it's very important. It's a very good cause. There's going to be kids coming up this Christmas time who aren't going to be as fortunate as ourselves, who won't be getting any toys. So if you could, just spare maybe like $5, buy an action figure, buy a Barbie or something, and let a kid who probably wouldn't have a toy this year actually maybe have a little bit more of a smile this year and have a toy to play with. So remember, Toys for Tots, that's November 20th, November 21st. We will be on remote here, also here in the studio, 24/7. So make sure Hertz Donut on Campus Corner here across the street from the OU campus. So, Jer, how you been?
I've been doing great, man. Can you believe there's only 49 days left in this year?
I just realized I'm going to Ireland in like 6 weeks.
49 days?
Something like that. It's going to be crazy. It's getting cold, though. I'm like, it's kind of cool, but yet again, I'm not too happy about it.
It's not cool going to Ireland?
No, it's
not. Is that what you're saying?
Oh.
Irish pride?
Of course not.
What happened to your Irish pride? Oh, when you shaved the stash. You trimmed it, guys. Remember, we were trying to auction that off to a lucky listener.
It's completely
gone. Nobody wanted it, man. Nobody wanted your facial pubes.
So, how about that football game Saturday?
Wow. Can you believe it? Isn't that the biggest loss to Baylor ever.
It's the biggest home loss under Coach Stoops.
Biggest home loss under Coach Stoops.
The last game, the biggest home loss prior to that was 2 years ago.
The biggest when home loss was prior to that 2 years ago.
Are you just going to repeat everything I say?
I don't know. I was trying to make it sound interesting. Well, you know what? We got a great show coming up. We're going to try extra cool little bit. So all you listeners, make sure you tune in, and you can play along on Facebook just by simply commenting on the actual page of our radio show, This and That. It's going to be a movie clip trivia. I got 10 clips. Actually, wasn't even done with it. Made Keegan cover his ears so he couldn't hear all of them.
Yeah, I had to listen to some, like, hardcore music.
I think the last one's going to be the hardest.
Yeah.
But the rest of them are all pretty simple and pretty straight up. I'm really interested to see what Thug Life says about all this, because it's going to be interesting. It's a new little bit we'll try. If it works, maybe we'll play it back again.
Hopefully,
best
yeah.
of or something.
I'm looking forward to it. I have no idea any of these clips, so.
And also, me and Keegan have been talking about doing an on-location recording. So as soon as we get a location, stay tuned to our Facebook page, because we will post that, and you guys can come out and join us, and we'll do a pre-recorded show, hopefully Sunday. That way, you know, you guys all have a we'll interview anybody who wants to come up and say hi.
Yeah, we were talking about this the other day. We thought it might be cool. I mean, Jeremy said he has the equipment available for us just to do it on remote podcast somewhere else. So we've been thinking, hey, you know.
And then we'll play it back next Wednesday, hopefully.
Maybe we can get some people, some friends of ours, come on. Just have
just
some
friends
fun.
Of the show, you know.
That means you, Dr. Ken. That means you, Brackstone.
That means you, Mr. Dave.
That means you, Mr. Dave.
That means
you, Obama.
Lyra.
That means you.
Uh-oh, I'm going to get a message here because I said her name.
Oh, no.
She's going to say, I'm not going anywhere with you.
That means you, Thug.
Yeah, Dairy Boy.
That means you.
Dairy Boy, clear your calendar. You will make an appearance whether you like. Dude, I will kidnap that guy.
No, that's illegal.
We will drug him up, and he won't even be able to see. He'll just be catatonic. We'll prop him up in the corner.
Where am I? You're on remote location here on This and That. Only on The Wire, your student radio. But, it's getting cold out here in Norman. That
so
wind.
One heck of a Monday, was it not?
What happened on Monday?
Dude, there was a
oh my goodness,
hostage
yes.
situation.
Holy cow.
Somebody got smushed by a car off of Lindsay right outside the stadium in Asp. Shut the whole bus system down for a little while. Luckily, I caught the last shuttle out. I didn't even know.
Yeah.
And then
there was a kid sitting on the
roof. He was just chilling, man.
Yeah, it's like suicide prevention thing going on across over at Adams Hall, right?
No, not Adams Hall. It was Adams Tower.
Adams Tower.
Yeah. But it was crazy, man. Like, the whole world was coming to an end
in
Norman.
Yeah, because it all happened, like, within 30 minutes of one another.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So
it was crazy.
Jeremy and I, we just went to go get a beer.
Yeah, we went to our safe place.
We're like, they can't hurt us here.
Nobody does wacky stuff where they serve
but
beer.
Shout out to the Norman Police Department for handling it so well. Actually, on Yahoo News, they actually had that hostage negotiation as one of their top stories. And, you know, shout out to the Norman Police Department. They actually had, like, their hands full of a wacky Monday. That's the last thing you want to do, anything on Mondays. No one likes Mondays. Bad case of the Mondays.
I don't know. That was crazy, though. I mean, I literally sat on the bus when the person got smushed. And, I don't know. I had my headphones on, just jamming away, sitting right behind the bus driver, so I couldn't see forward. And then all of a sudden, I look around, and everybody on the bus start like standing up, like little meerkats. You know how they do, where they kind of stretch to the neck and start looking. And so I look, and I seen a bunch of stoppage out in the road, and I'm like, man, what's going on here? And take my earphones off, and you can hear the radio chatter. All the bus drivers are like asking for permission from whatever their head honcho to divert and. We were luckily. I just made. He actually was waiting on me. He seen me walking, and so I kind of like mall walked really quick. You know, got the fist going.
Professional speed walking.
Yeah, dude. I look like the
like
best.
A, like a pro
professional speed walker trying to get to that bus. But as soon as I got on, he closed the door and we took off. And luckily, I made it because if not, I would have been like, "Where's all the buses?" Because there was none. I mean,
yeah, you had to drive me home actually because of the whole ordeal.
He was drunk, man.
I was so
hammered. Yeah, I had to hold your hair back while you puke.
No, the buses were unable to,
had to hold your beard.
Take me to the Lloyd Noble, so Jeremy ended up taking me home.
I took him home.
So, yeah, we apparently our show is reaching other colleges now. We are receiving word from a friend of mine that people have been listening over at Benedictine College in Kansas, which is kind of cool. The fact that there's some people listening over in Kansas.
Word up to those college people. So, what college did you say that was?
Benedictine's College. Benedictine. It's a Catholic college. Private school, I believe.
Well,
my
that's
friend Kevin
awesome.
Actually goes there. But we're going to have a singer-songwriter from there on our to call in a little bit.
Oh, wow, that's great.
I hope I'm pronouncing it right. Jackie Trecko. She'll probably correct us later, but she'll be calling us in a few minutes.
Pardon if there's a mispronounced
pronunciation. Yeah, we apologize. But, yeah, it's kind of cool that we're actually reaching
and from what
states.
I hear, she's a really good singer-songwriter.
Yeah,
right?
I was watching some of her videos earlier today, and I was like, oh, that's really nice. Really good, really positive, uplifting, motivational kind of acoustic band music. So if you're interested, be sure to stay tuned, and we're going to hopefully have her on in the next couple of minutes. So, but, yeah. We're expanding.
We're moving forward. Hey, and for the listeners who's curious what's going to happen after the break or during the break, we're going to actually try to work on a couple pre-records and get a couple shows going for you and release them week by week. Maybe even if I can get all the shows that we have, do like a best of during the Christmas week. That way, you know, you guys can stay tuned and listen to that on the interweb.
Yeah, Jeremy and I, we really pride ourselves on our little show here.
We've actually wanted to do this for a long time.
We've been, when people ask us, you know, why did you guys decide this format of the show? Back when we were at Rose State, we've always been just like messing around, doing little funny podcasts on his computer with his microphones and stuff. So when we got the chance to actually do it for a class / you know, practicum internship, we're like, heck yeah. We're going to try our best to make it the best thing we can possibly do.
And we couldn't do it without you guys.
Yeah, you know, we have over 256 likes in less than a semester.
That's more than the actual station itself.
Yeah, the Wire Radio Station's Facebook page does not have that many. We beat them by like 13 so much. So, you know, thanks again to everybody who's spread the word, who's liked our page, who listens to our show. I know it's sometimes hard to come up at 9 in the morning to listen to our show, but for those of you who listen every day, and I gotta give props to Mr. Dr. Ken. Dr. Ken is probably our
number one
listener,
biggest fan,
and we can't thank you enough, Doc.
Literally and figuratively.
Though he is a doctor, he is
cheap
not a licensed
shot, Dr.
physician.
Ken.
Detroit stinks, though. Red Wings are Red not Wings. Good. I'm sorry to say it.
I gotta go to the page and see what he's saying back to us now.
He's like waffles, Dr. Man cakes, right there.
Oh, look at that. We got a... I forgot about that one. Cool.
What did you forget?
Oh, our beer of the week comes from a listener.
Yeah, I actually saw
that.
I saw that on our page the other day.
So
I'm like,
people
great.
Show that they're listening and they're interested. So you too can be part of the show. Just make sure you submit stuff via Facebook or even to our email, which I don't ever check.
Yeah,
I think Keegan checks that.
Beer of the week, you know, if you have actually a cool news story, funny news story that happened, you know, send us the link. Send us links to cool things.
Yeah,
we always like check our Facebook page. So always, you know, we love the fan to audience relationship, student spotty. What?
Oh, no, I'm eating.
What are you eating?
Pumpkin bread.
Ew.
It was really good.
I do not like pumpkins.
Well, they didn't have, what was that called? Banana nut bread. That's my go-to.
Didn't have pumpkin spice latte?
Nope.
Ow. Lattes are ow.
Pike's Place Roast Black.
Yeah. He's drinking his little Starbucks.
What were we saying?
Something about... I like
listeners.
How we have our listener to...
Oh, yeah, dude. Our
host
one listener.
Relationship. Yeah, Braxton and Ken and sometimes Mr... Has Mr. Dave ever listened to our show?
And our people up there in Benedictine College.
Benedictines, yeah.
That's
pretty
cool.
Shout out to Kevin Brown.
Shout out to all of them. All of them awesome listeners.
Make sure to spread the word. Tell all your friends. And maybe we can have some kind of connection. Some Benedictine's OU connection.
Yeah, man. Hey, comment on our page if you're listening. If you got the chance to listen, we'll definitely give you guys a shout-out. I'm fixing to throw the shout-out thing up there because last time I put it up so late, we got a whole bunch later after the show was over.
Probably
so
best do it now. Then we can just do them all at the end.
And all you guys have to do as a listener is just simply click like on that post, and we'll give you a shout-out.
Yeah.
So, it was pretty cool because I think we had like a total of like 15, 20 shout-outs plus our ongoing shout-outs that don't need to like it because we know you listen.
It's dedication at its finest. So, yeah. Make sure to go and do that right now. Facebook.com / this and that Wire. That again is facebook.com/thisandthatwire. Not the letter, not the word and, but the letter N. So I think, Jeremy, we are going to try to get Jackie on the show. You cool with that?
Yeah, man. All right. Let's go ahead and go to a break. And if you're listening, Jackie, give us a call.
I'm going to send you that phone number you call us right now. So you're listening to This and That on The Wire, your student radio. So, yeah, thank you. We'll be back.
Keegan and Jeremy on The Wire, This and That. Listen online.
Bronco.
Stephen Thorne, such a sweet soul. That man is amazing. I hope we're trying to get him back on the show. That's going to be cool. He's a really nice guy. I believe we have Jackie all the way from Benedictine's College, and I think it's Lawrence, Kansas.
Lawrence, Kansas.
Jackie, can you hear us? Hello?
Yeah. Hi.
How
it's
are you?
It's actually Atchison.
Oh, it's Atchison. Yeah, I get them mixed up.
It's an itty-bitty town, so it's hard to... it's easy to miss, so...
So, Jackie...
I'm doing well.
How did you hear about our show and, like, all that cool stuff?
I go to school with, I think, a friend of yours, Kevin Brown. He was in my accounting class, actually, last year, and we did music a little bit together last year, and then he heard that I was really trying to pursue music, and so he was like, hey, you should talk to these people, and now here I am.
That's really cool, yeah. Kevin's a really cool guy. Funny story, his cousin was my next-door neighbor when I was 1 year old. We didn't find that out
until
I was in college, and I ended up being in the same class with him. But
that's crazy.
For all the listeners out there, we have links to Jackie's music on our Facebook page, so make sure to go on there. You can find her SoundCloud and some YouTube videos of her. So, Jackie, how would you describe your music? We were listening to it a little bit earlier.
I guess like the easiest genre to put it in is like acoustic singer songwriter folk, that those genres. But I describe my music as really lyric heavy, in that like my instrumentation is really simple, but the words are really more of what matters to me. I make the instruments beautiful, but not complicated, because I'm, you know, I'm not as gifted in that area. But I just love to play for people, so sometimes like, I draw inspiration from stories I'm hearing of other people. Sometimes it's like things in my own life, but they're all like meant to help in some way or another, like whether that's like helping to process or just helping get over something or like being happy about something. Or, yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, like, speaking of inspiration, who would you say that music-wise, other artists, who would you say that inspired you the most? Like what type of artists do you kind of look up to? And
well, now, like recently I've been really into the Oh Hellos, the Head and the Heart, Noah Gunderson, and people like that. But when I was growing up, like when I was starting to write, I listened a lot to like Jason Mraz and Kolby Kelly, and then Sarah Bareilles. She was actually really big because I liked her creativity, and Ingrid Michaelson as well.
So mostly a lot of singer-songwriters themselves.
Yeah. And but I grew up listening to like a bunch of different kind of music because my parents have a really eclectic taste.
So why did you decide to go to Benedictine's of all places?
It's a good question. I decided to go because I found a community here that I didn't find anywhere else.
That's really awesome.
Yeah, it was really beautiful, and it's continued to be that way. It wasn't just something I saw and then didn't ever find here, so it was really cool.
So do you play shows at like local establishments and stuff?
Yeah, actually, like right now I'm working with somebody in Weston, which is about 20 minutes away, to have a show out there. I play on campus a lot, and we have a campus coffee house off campus technically, and so I play there. I've just played a show at a winery in St. Genevieve, Missouri, which is the other side of the state. And yeah, so I've just been like picking up different places pretty gradually, actually.
So where are you going to be for our listeners up there and other people who might be in the area? Where are you going to be playing, like, coming up?
I'm actually opening for Judah and the Lion at Benedictine College on November 21st.
Oh, cool.
So,
Do you have any funny, like, crazy stories, like traveling?
Yeah, what's the craziest thing?
We like to know if everybody's any, like, funny stories or anything.
Craziest thing that's happened to you at a show or on the way to a show or coming home from a show?
Oh, man. there's a lot to pick from. My sister and I sing together a lot. And so if you hear her on my SoundCloud, she's the one that's singing with me. So pretty much any time I get in the car with her, it's hilarious. But there was this one time we were coming back from being in St. Louis this summer, and we stopped at a mall, and I've never felt so basic as I did in this moment because I had my iPhone out, like, getting directions. I had Starbucks in my hand, and I was getting off of an exit, and I hit a curb and got a flat tire, and it was pretty basic.
Did you spill, like, your coffee everywhere and everything?
No, actually, I felt kind of like a champ because my coffee didn't spill and my iPhone wasn't broken in some sense or another. So
the important things stay the same. All the other stuff just broke.
Right. Coffee for days.
Well, as long as you're okay, that's all that matters.
I appreciate that.
The music's got to go on, right?
So yep. What are you majoring in at Benedictine's?
I'm majoring in theology and evangelization and catechesis. So okay. I'm double majoring.
So what would you like to do once you're out of school?
I'd really like to do music, honestly. I know that sounds kind of crazy because I'm paying to get a degree, but I think that the degree that I've gotten has really formed me as a person, and the more that I pursued my degree in theology, the more I realized that, like, I have talents that I need to share with people, and that, like, that's the way that the Lord can work through my life, is by utilizing my talents. And so even if that's not, like, me singing Christian music, because my music isn't overtly Christian, like, I'm not a Christian artist, but just the fact that, like, I've encountered this reality within Catholicism, and, like, that's changed me, like, that's affected and has caused me to challenge me to pursue music, really. So we'll see where it goes.
If you had one food you could eat for the rest of your life, and it was, like, the healthiest thing for you, what would you eat?
My mom's curry chicken and rice.
Ooh,
hands
down,
really not
good.
Even a second thought.
I haven't had curry in a long time. That sounds great.
It's delicious. It's like I'm half Bahamian, half American. So this casserole is like a dish. That's exactly who I am. Because it's a casserole, which is really Midwestern, and then, or hot dish if you're in Minnesota. And then it's curry chicken, which is a really Bahamian staple, really big Bahamian staple. And so my mom, like, put them together, and it's so good.
Mm.
With cheese.
You should send us some.
Okay, I might. If I'm ever in Oklahoma, I'll have to, like, stop by.
And, oh, crap, what was I going to say? Oh, man, it just escaped me. Dang it.
Brain bug. Well...
I don't know. I gotta figure this out. I gotta figure out what I was gonna say.
Do do do.
Yeah, exactly. Where's the Jeopardy music?
I'm gonna wake up tomorrow morning like, now I remember.
It'll text me and be like, ah, I figured it out.
But if you know any other musicians that mm-hmm. were interested in maybe having a little time out here on our show, please let them know, mm-hmm. Jackie.
Yeah. Yeah. No, I would love to.
If you could
spread the word and let everybody there know that there's an awesome radio show. And we're not just exclusive to the University of Oklahoma. We are on the web. So we talk a little bit of sports here and stuff that we got to. And I remind the students of certain programs that are available here. But other than that, it's a general
subject. I remember now.
I was trying to buy you time.
Well, on our show, we do a beer of the week. And do you have a favorite beer?
Yes. I do. Right now, I'm, like, honestly, I walked into the school year. I turned 21 over the summer, and
can you do us a favor?
Yeah.
Can you put that on our Facebook page? Because I hate to mention one, because we already got one from another listener. But drop us a comment with that one and a link to
the beer. Or you just text it to me.
Or, yeah, you can text it that way. That way we'll have it next week, and we'll throw it all the way out there and give you props for it.
Yeah, awesome. Well.
So, listeners, stay tuned. Dun dun dun. What the beer of the week will be.
It's really yummy.
Hey, but it was great having you on the show. And as always, stay warm. I know it's probably cold up there because it's really chilly down here.
It's like, feels like negative something outside
right
now.
Oh, goodness.
Wow.
Yeah, it's gross.
So.
Not made for this.
Once again, if you guys want to go on our Facebook page, you can see links to Jackie's music. So Jackie, thank you so much for coming in, for talking to us for a little bit.
Yeah, and thanks for having me.
Absolutely. So
speaking of the cold, I'm going to go ahead and segue straight into the weather, because it is getting cold out, and we all know that some people like the cold, some people hate it. I really like it personally myself, because you can always put more clothes on. But today, it looks like we're going to high of 35 degrees, a low of 21 with 0% chance of precip. Winds coming out of the north at 17 miles per hour. And tomorrow, it looks like we're going to have a high of 37 with a low of 21. It looks like we're going to warm up for just a little bit, but not much. It's going to be partly cloudy most of the week and on into Saturday, where it looks like there's going to be a light wintry mix. Highs in the 40s for Friday and Saturday, lows in the 20s, and then Sunday comes the dun-dun-dun bad weather. So make sure you guys bundle up, take all the precautions, bring your plants in, because I'm an avid green thumb, and I know your plants don't like being out in the cold. They told me.
Yeah, my mom told me, too.
Yeah, I always bag my plants. I got some strawberry plants. It's been with me for 4 years now. They make some awesome strawberries, dude.
You want a cookie?
Oh, dude, I want a strawberry. That's what I want.
I feel like Thug Life should be coming on the show sometime.
Yeah, when we come back, we'll bring Thug Life on. I gotta get his intro music ready.
Oh, snap. He's got his own intro music?
I think it was Dairy Boys, but we'll go ahead and make it Thug Life. Either way, Sunday, snow showers. Chance of snow, 50%. You know how it is in Oklahoma. Could be 50, could be 100, could be zero. Winds are going to come out of the north all week long, except for Friday and Saturday, where they're out of the south, and it's going to try to fight off, and then that's where the wintry mix is going to come. I'm not a meteorologist. Speaking of meteorologists, we need to get your buddy coming in.
Speaking of weathermen, we just got a text message from our good friend Emily Morris, who
says
you sound like a professional weatherman.
Yeah, I just like randomly talk because I'm hyped up on coffee. Either way, you're listening to This and That.
It's the show that ruins your college experience.
Keegan and Jeremy, you guys suck.
This and That on the Wire, your student radio.
That's always a good one. I like it. Thank you, Lyra Lou.
Thanks, Lyra.
You know she really meant that when she said it.
At least for me.
Yeah, well, you know who we got coming up next, right? Or who we got in the studio.
We got Thug Life in the studio.
Oh, yeah. We would like to introduce Thug Life.
Thug Life.
How's it going, Thug
Life?
What's
going on? What's going on, y'all? Good to be here. I'm finally on the show. For taking you guys long enough to get me on, so.
On the record, his name really isn't Thug Life, but we're not going to tell you what his real name is.
Yeah. But I didn't choose that life. That life chose me.
So how's it going, man?
Not too bad. Trying to stay bundled up in this freezing weather. So
you don't like the cold? I like the cold.
Oh, I love the cold. Big guys like us, we got to love the cold.
I know,
man.
Dude, because I got my winter coat on all year long.
Yeah, exactly. I look slim. I'm slimming down. Ladies are getting a little bit more interested.
They need something warm. They need something to keep them warm. Ain't that right, Lyra? So, man, I see you on the sidelines all the time. What do you do?
Me?
Yeah, I see you following around Stormy, but...
Basically, I'm there for moral support for coaches, basically. They're always coming to me, you know, shoulders to cry on, stuff like that. Anyone ever needs, you know, a couple plays. That's where I'm, you know, basically creative management kind of stuff. Now, I don't do much on the sidelines. I bring microphones to people who need them, and I roll cable when I need to, or...
Dude, you want to trade jobs? Because
staying around look pretty.
Yeah, you want to trade jobs with me?
Unfortunately, I can't. It's something that's been set out. I was chosen.
Jesus put this in front of me.
He pulled a sword. He pulled a sword out of a rock and was like, "You will be my assistant."
He pulled a mic out of a mic stand. Yeah. And
the one that no one else could pull
out.
I rolled the
unrollable XLR.
So. Thug Life, what plays should we pick? I do play action. Play action pass should work.
Yeah.
Touchdown.
I almost went out there on Saturday. I was about to throw some pads on, see if I couldn't help our boys out a little bit, but by the time that rolled
train
around.
Train wreck.
It was
very disorganized. However, I feel Bob, you know, he's a professional. He knows what to do. He will adapt, and they will be stronger than they ever were before.
He will persevere.
He will overcome.
He's like, he was like, Obi-Wan Kenobi, you can strike me down, Darth, but I'll become more powerful than you can possibly imagine. And then Obi-Wan Kenobi ends up dying.
So he was wrong, so we're not going to use that.
No, we're not going to use that one. No, not at all.
Take that one back.
So for those of you who don't know Thug Life, which no one should technically know who
Thug
Life is.
Yeah, hey, do you have a Twitter?
I do not.
Good.
I think I do. But
I only use mine for drunk tweets. Like when instead of doing drunk texts or drunk calls, like I'm like, oh, Twitter. Let me see. What if I can piss somebody off?
Why are you tonight? That's why you're always talking to me on your Twitter.
Exactly.
Huh?
I'm like, what are you wearing, Keegan?
Yeah. See, I just ask Keegan. I don't know. I'm always sending texts like that.
Like I know what he's wearing. He's always laying next to me.
Ooh. Hello. All you listeners out there, get a little. Love.
That's Thug Life.
I have no comment. This is not
he's
factual.
Like, I have no comment. I'm not wearing anything.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Hey, speaking of seeing what people are wearing, look there you go.
There he is.
If you're looking online,
we got to do.
Here I am.
Here's our handshake. We have this cool hand. Well, this is our abridged
Thug
version.
Life. So check it out online. They're clapping. They're
ooh,
snapping. They're flapping.
Inspired by Lil Terrio.
And that's what happened for all the radio listeners.
Ooh.
Kill him.
Killing it.
So where did y'all come up with that? I gotta ask that.
Well, there was a vine on Vine. There's a little...
No, not that would kill him. The clap and flap thing that you do.
I don't know. Yeah,
it just it came to us in the moment, the inspiration.
Yeah.
You know.
We worked together, like, when we first started at Soonervision volleyball, we were, like, utilities and helping out, and
yep.
we would have to block the volleyballs from hitting the talent. So we were just... I'm like, we all look like a bunch of thugs, so I started saying Thug Life.
And that's how the legend was born.
And he actually in my phone is Thug Life.
Really?
My phone is Thug Life.
You're in mine.
You should have
Thug
a
Life
Facebook page
named
Thug Life.
Thug Life?
I'll
yeah, like a
it,
character
yeah.
page.
I don't got a lot of time right now for extra Facebook
man,
pages.
Man, who does?
I know. I got to put
it's
the
that time
in
of the
for
year.
The listeners. It's that time of the year.
I'm telling you,
it's
man.
Extra
like,
it's that time of that month. It's that time of the month.
Not for me. I mean, wait.
So, other than Soonervision, you work at Benvenuti's off Main
I
Street.
Do
you
I
work
do.
At Benvenuti's?
I
didn't know
am,
that.
Yeah, I work at Benvenuti's.
Are you
I
the am, head cook?
No.
Head busboy?
Very close to head busboy, but no. I'm a head bartender. No, I'm bartender, and I serve a little bit on the side.
Bartender. Bartender extraordinaire.
Exactly.
So we should,
mixologist.
He should have a fair share of points for our beer of the week this week.
Oh,
I'm a medic for the soul.
Yeah.
For those of you who would like to come in and
I've heard that from
you.
Other people.
I believe you told me that.
Did I tell you that?
Uh-huh. Maybe you told me that.
You know what? I think I did.
He's like, that's who I heard
the one
time.
The one time I came to Benvenuti's and you were
told
working, you're like, you know what they say about bartenders? They're the medics of the soul.
I've been trying to get a business card ever since, but Benvenuti's isn't
Thug
going
Thug Life,
it.
Medic of the soul. Soul medic.
Soul medic. Ooh, there you go. Cut it down.
And then there's like a slash, or in parentheses, just a cool guy.
A very pleasant fellow.
Do you like bartending?
Yeah. Bartending's a lot of fun. I mean, you're making drinks. You're learning how to make all these drinks that you've heard of forever that, you know, you never had any idea how they are, what they taste like. Now you have some idea. You're talking to people. Everyone likes you because you're giving them alcohol. It's a pretty sweet gig.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you were telling me the other day, you guys got because it's an Italian restaurant, you guys have some somewhat expensive bottles of wine and alcohol.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
You were telling me you had like a 3-liter bottle
mm-hmm.
somebody bought. How much was that?
That was, after tax, it was about
$470. $470
yep.
for a 3-liter bottle of wine.
So it's basically four bottles of wine in one huge bottle. Imagine that.
Wow.
And this is like some pretty expensive wine by itself. But then they put four bottles of it into one.
Was it good?
I never got to try it. They don't, unfortunately. But
so
it smelled good.
You were telling me like the people that bought it were thinking about.
Was it like a wedding or something?
It.
No, I mean it was a small table. It was a four top of guys. Only three of them even ended up drinking any of the wine, and when I was opening it, I pulled the cork out and the cork had had a little wine soaked up into it, and it was kind of falling apart, which is like usually a sign that the wine has turned, that it's aged too much, it's
vinegar.
Gonna lose its yeah, and so he tried it, but. Luckily, after I opened the $300 or $470 bottle, he decided he wanted it after all. So,
You gotta be like, too bad, you bought it already.
That's what I was saying. I was like, that came out of the bottle. That's yours, sir. But nah.
Is that the most expensive drink you guys got over there?
I think that is our most expensive bottle. I'm not sure. I don't.
Because remember, like, you have some bottles like up on a pedestal with lights.
Yeah, we have the Louis 13th cognac, and that is that's very expensive cognac. It's about
I'm not even a cognac drinker, but I know that's some good stuff.
$185 a glass, like a shot.
Really?
Yeah, about $100 an ounce usually.
And that's from Louis the 13th.
That's from Louis the 13th. The bottle itself, once it's empty, we sell for $500. People buy it.
So does Benvenuti sell those, or?
I mean, we only have one bottle at a time because there's not a lot of need for it. But I mean, yeah, we do sell it occasionally.
What's the menu like over there?
Oh man, they got everything. They got we got pasta, pizza, steaks, chicken, seafood, monthly specials.
What's the monthly special for November?
There's three dishes. We have the grilled quail, the penne rustica, and some braised lamb shank.
Yeah. Well, we got Keegan putting Benvenuti's on our Facebook. So all you listeners can go check it out.
Go check it out. Go to Amazon Local. They probably won't be telling you guys this, but
we can't do any call to action on this nonprofit radio.
You're exactly right.
However, it will be on our Facebook page if you'd like to
if you'd like to check it out.
Yeah. It's there.
And if you'd like, there's
I don't know, I've heard everybody talk about it in Norman. So
on certain websites as well. Yeah. It's a good place. The food.
Where can somebody go for a good discount?
Amazon Local offers you spend 30, you get 60 at Benvenuti's.
So it's like a 50% off.
Yeah, it's like 50% off kind of deal. So
I gotta let my mom know about that. Because we're gonna go, I think, next week.
Do it.
We're having some family come in.
They probably don't want me telling people this, but yeah, it's a great deal. And if you'd like, check it out. Definitely. You got to check out the pizza. I've been when I was in Italy and I came back here. This is the closest I've had to Italian pizza.
Well, that's right. You studied in Italy for a bit.
A bit.
You speak a little Italian, don't you?
That's
amore. When the moon hits your eyes, full of pizza pies. That's amore.
Is that the foreign language you took?
Yeah.
Online or?
No, I took them all here.
That was funny because I'll see him like in the horseshoe at Senior Vision, and all his notes are in Italian. I'm like, he's an Italian guy.
So are you Italian?
No,
I'm not.
Did
you just say that? Did I miss that part?
I wish I was. I'm like Irish and American because I don't even know what I am. I think I know I'm from Ireland.
You personally from Ireland?
Yeah, I was born there.
Oh yeah?
No, but I wish.
Hey, you know, was either one of your parents? Either one of your parents?
Either of them.
Born in Ireland?
No.
Because, you know, Ireland is one of those places where you can file for dual citizenship if you can just prove that you're from there.
Yeah. Apparently we had to do a report when I was in Italy over, like, where we came from as far as, like, you know, how our family got to America.
And you're like, my mama's womb.
And my grandma told me that her grandfather was 12 years old when he came over here from Ireland during the famine, and he snuck onto a ship at 12 years old and made it to, like, New York.
Wow. Yeah. Imagine being 12 at New York.
Imagine sneaking on a ship and going across the world to a place you've never been.
A language you can't speak. And New York at that time was like...
not a place to be.
Skyscrapers, either. That was like beyond anybody's comprehension.
That scared me. He said ship, and then you're like, language you can't speak. I'm like, did he just cuss? And then I'm like, he's talking about America. Ships. He's talking about America.
Talking about ships.
Sailing vessels, if you will.
I believe Diversity was an old wooden ship that was built during the Civil War era, actually. By Jove.
That is completely incorrect.
That was crazy.
San Diego.
Is that your grandpa's name?
San Diego?
San Diego?
Carmen San Diego?
Where in the world is Carmen San Diego? That's where
whatever
his mom
happened,
is.
Where did she ever end up?
I think they found her, so I think that's why.
I think they found her at the end of every episode.
Ooh, okay, wow.
In a cemetery.
They got real dark.
With a big red hat.
Usually where you'd find corpses.
Next to Waldo.
Waldo's covered in all red now. He's done got the stripes.
Gross.
So, Thug Life, you graduated last winter.
Yes. December 2013.
You were, what, FMS major?
I was, with a minor in Italian.
Bobbity boopity?
Hippity hoppity.
So, what would you like to do other than what you're doing now?
I'd love to be a documentary filmmaker.
Oh, yeah?
Where do you see yourself in 10 years?
In 10 years, hopefully somewhere
else.
Living life, being happy.
Celebrating the 10-year anniversary of
you
asking me
that question. I'm not really
sure.
I don't want to set milestones for myself and then end up being disappointed later on because I don't know where life's going to take me. I didn't think I was ever going to be working at Soonervision or sports broadcasting, and here I am talking to you guys. So
I know. That's how you met us.
Yeah, exactly. So that's what I'm saying. I mean, you know, me making plans for myself is a joke just because who knows where I'll be in 10 years. But I'll be happy. Hopefully I'll be healthy.
I think it's healthy to have an outline but not like
absolutely.
A definite plan. You know what I mean?
Yeah. I mean, I have some ideas. Like, I'd love to continue with sports broadcasting.
I know, you know, when I was your age, I was sitting there telling myself, I want to party in every capital city before I die.
Kill them.
I made it to 46, man. 46 of them.
You didn't make it to Juneau, did you?
No.
Or Honolulu?
Or Honolulu.
Or Oklahoma City.
No.
Well, yeah, what do you have left besides Honolulu and Juneau?
What was it?
Des Moines?
No. what is it?
Montpelier.
No, Montpelier?
I don't know
the capital. Salem. You guys are killing
it. No, what's the capital of Oregon?
Salem,
yeah. I haven't been to Salem. And haven't been to... Not Maryland. What's West Virginia? I haven't ever stepped foot in West Virginia.
Yeah, me neither. I'm not going to lie to you.
I have. That's I forget.
It.
What is
the rest of them?
What is?
So what was the best?
I traveled around the world. Okay.
Best capital city?
Best capital city you partied in.
I would have to say Oklahoma City. No. It's because we were all my friends out there.
It's probably where you did it the most.
The most fun. I don't know, man. Boise was wild, but it was the people that I was there with, man.
Those potato vodka concoctions they'd make.
Denver was always cool.
Yeah, for sure. Denver's a good place to be.
I don't know. I'd have to say Peoria.
Huh?
Yeah.
Peoria? That's
Puera?
Puera.
What are you talking about?
Illinois, right?
I have no idea.
Chicago?
Chicago's the capital of Illinois.
Isn't it?
You guys are looking at the wrong.
Look it up. Maybe I partied in the wrong.
maybe you're missing five, buddy.
Springfield.
Springfield.
That's what it was, Springfield.
What were you saying? Peoria?
Peoria?
Did you make that place?
Right. Aurora?
Aurora?
Aurora? That's the suburb of Chicago. That's where Wayne's World's from.
No.
Wayne's World.
Party. I don't know. Great maybe stuff. There's 10 of them I'm missing. Brain cells.
Wayne's World, live radio, talk about live TV. That's crazy. I was watching this special on 90s SNL, and they were talking to, it was Mike Myers talking about how he was doing a cold open, and they were doing the Wayne's World skit, and it was like 92, 93, right when we had just invaded Kuwait. And he's sitting there saying 33 seconds before they went on, they had to rewrite their entire clip because they had just invaded Kuwait. So
what was the clip about?
It was just doing Wayne's World, and so they just like talked about like they're like, well, we just acted like we were two kids sitting on the couch watching it for the first time, like everyone else was in America. And he's talking about scuds and how he thought a scud was a girl who looked pretty from far away, but when she got close, she was a scud. That's just
that's crazy.
She's a scud.
And I've never heard of that one before. You know, we've gotten older. You know, when we were in high school, we were all up on the hip and the now with the words. Now there's all these words that I don't even understand.
I agree. Yeah.
Like bae, B-A-E.
Bacon and eggs, man. That's what I'm thinking
I like
every
that.
Time.
I thought it was like we're shortening the word babe.
I think that's what it was, basically.
But now it's, but before all others.
Like one person was trying to text babe and they just missed a B because they're going too fast. And they just spelled bae and then it just.
Before all everyone? I don't know. And then my brother mentioned the word salty.
My roommate has been saying salty a lot, and at first I didn't know if it meant like, I mean, I guess it means like getting kind of like,
man, like, man, you salty.
Angry,
I was
like,
dude, I heard my like little nephew, well, he was little then, he was like 13, 14, and him and all his friends used to say salty.
Salty.
And that was about 5, 6
ooh,
years
that
ago.
Girl, salty.
She's salty, girl.
She
ooh.
Salty.
Ooh.
Man, he's salty
very
right
salty.
Now for that.
You
like
smell
Bob
that?
Stoops would have been salty.
You smell that? It smells like salt, because you salty, girl.
Got some sodium? Cause
what else? Yeah, you want some fries with that salt?
Ooh, nice. I like it.
Well, I'll tell you what. Let's go to some music. When we come back, we'll have some news.
Let me pick the song then.
Okay, pick the song, because I'm going to tease some news right now. We got a lot of old women in the news today.
Ew.
Killed them.
Ooh, and we also got a robber who had a change of heart. So, that and two old women doing crazy things just like they normally do.
It's not too late. It's never too late.
You are listening
to The Wire? Your OU student radio?
You're listening to This and That on The Wire.
Huh?
Your student radio.
You're listening to This and That with Keegan.
Let me just tell a story and I can make it really good.
And Jeremy.
I'm covered in blood. The pig is dead on the ground.
On The Wire, your student radio. That guy that we got for the voiceover, he's so cool. Welcome back to This and That. Keegan Meehan, along with me always, my partner in crime, the goondog millionaire himself, Jeremy Deere.
Yeah.
We got Thug Life in the house, Real Talk, Rucker Park, West Side, North Side, South Side, East Side. West Side.
Church, represent.
We are on every Wednesday morning, once again, from 9 to 11, Central Standard Time, of course. Why, you may ask? Because we live in the heart of America, Oklahoma, that's right. So, Thug Life is in the house, Jeremy's in the house, we got all the goondogs in the house. So, Jer.
What up?
What's going on?
What are we doing?
Some news?
We doing that news-ish, girl. Ooh.
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 Ooh. Kill him.
Ooh.
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 News. Gonna do some news.
Travis.
Yeah,
Brazil.
We could use some news. Everybody else could, too. We got some crazy stuff, as always. Three quick little stories we got going on here. Out of Eureka, California. You know, that's where they come with the term Eureka.
Really?
Yeah, because it was a gold rush town. Anyways.
Oh,
out of,
okay. That's cool.
Eureka, California. Police in Northern California say a man robbed a gas station only to return hours later to, guess what?
Give it back.
Give the money back. Yep.
What a nice criminal.
Good guy.
Well, he also included an apology, but apparently that wasn't good enough because... Eureka Police Sergeant Steve Watson said Sunday that 23-year-old Cly Warren Abbott Jr. told officers that he needed the cash to leave town for a fresh start, but then he realized he made a mistake, and that was demanding cash and walking out of a store with it.
Yeah.
Watson said Abbott first entered the gas station demanding the cash and with what the clerk believed was a semi-automatic handgun. He says the clerk gave Abbott some cash and Abbott left, also taking two bottles of beer. Did he return the beer? That's the question.
You're going to jail for just the beer.
Yeah.
Hey, dude, that's probably a restable offense, man.
If it was my beer, it'd be a restable offense. I know that.
Never take beer.
Depends on what kind of beer he took.
Hey,
what if he returned
Natty
the
Ice.
Beer and kept the money?
If he was Natty Ice, I think he'd probably get away with it.
You're right.
That's crazy, man. Well, he had a good heart. He realized he was too drunk to leave town, so he's like, well...
Like, I can't drive. Yeah.
Screw that idea.
Eureka. I'm coming back.
I feel like people go to Eureka to start new. Like, yeah, Eureka.
He probably found some gold and was like, I'll just give back the money. Oh, snap, I got to go to jail?
You think when he was thinking of the plan, he said Eureka? He was like, I got to get out of here. I got to start somewhere new. What should I do?
Eureka.
Eureka.
Or maybe he was like... Oh, I should give the money back. Eureka!
Yeah.
Little light bulb pops up on his head.
So maybe if I give it back,
I won't go to jail.
Eureka!
But maybe if I didn't take it in the first place, I know I wouldn't go to jail.
Yeah.
Eureka!
I wonder how old that gets for the people who live there.
Would you really want to live there?
Guess not. If that guy's that desperate,
Eureka!
If he's that desperate to get out, maybe I don't want to.
I just picture, like, instead of saying welcome to Eureka, it just says Eureka! It doesn't tell you when it was established or anything. It's just like, there's like three exclamation marks, but it's really old.
And it's one of those, like, yeah, it's one of those old school PowerPoint designs. So, like, you know what I'm saying?
No.
No. All right, well. Fair enough. Thank you.
Yeah.
Well, our next story goes to show that no matter what age or how popular you are, you can always be shown up. Because that's exactly what, well, let's just start with this, man. Former President George H.W. Bush celebrated his 90th birthday. And what did he do to celebrate it? He skydived. He leaped from a moving plane way up there in the air. Well, Eleanor Cunningham thought that she would show him up. And maybe that's not her whole purpose in doing this, but she beat him. She made the big leap to mark her centennial.
Wow.
So, Cunningham, she kissed her seven-month-old great-great granddaughter before suiting up for her 100th birthday jump Saturday at Saratoga skydiving in, hold on, let me see if I can pronounce this, Gansevoort,
that's New York. Yeah, New York, that's a Dutch town.
Yeah, it was her third jump after taking up the sport at age 90, so she figured if he could do it, she could do it.
Yeah, for a second I thought you were like, yeah, that George H.W. Bush, he did it like a while back, not like a while, like a year ago, and I was like, that's not a new story. And then you said, oh, it's a 100-year-old lady doing it.
Yeah, well, Cunningham, pretty she lives impressive. With her granddaughter in their Schoharie County home in central New York. Her doctor, of course, signed off on the skydiving expedition, saying her health makes her more than capable of doing what she loves.
That's really cool.
Man.
Can I go to skydiving for my 100th?
You seen that one video of the girl who... Or the old lady who's like shirts, she starts falling out.
Yeah.
Her skin's like flapping.
I mean, that's like some guts.
She didn't even know she was in danger.
Yeah.
I saw a video of a guy who, it was his 21st birthday. He was passed out drunk. Then his friends put him on one of those planes, strapped him up to one of the guys. He was unconscious. And as soon as they jumped out, he awoke.
You think that was real?
The skydiving. Oh my God. Yeah. I think it was real. It looked real.
I'd be really angry with you guys. But yeah, if you get that drunk where you can do all that without waking up, getting a loud plane, like getting manhandled by your friends into a jumpsuit.
Getting
like,
strapped to another guy.
You deserve it.
You deserve to be thrown out of that plane. No doubt.
Well, our next story takes us all the way to Florida.
And it would
dun, be. Dun, dun, dun. Happened in Florida. You know what happens in Florida.
Everything.
Florida.
Everything you talk about. It don't stay in Florida. Deputies in Florida say 81-year-old man... Oh, I thought it was a woman. That's crazy.
Whoa, man.
A whoa, man. 80-year-old man picked thousands of tangerines, 11 truckloads worth, and then sold the stolen bounty at a nearby market. Herman Southall was charged Wednesday with 11 counts of transporting citrus without a certificate, grand theft of more than 2,000 pieces of citrus, and trespassing. He's being held at Polk County Jail on a $8,500 bond.
Did you say Polk County Jail?
Yeah, that's crazy, man. How do they know 2,000?
Transporting without a citrus license?
Without a certificate?
What does that mean? I'm sorry. You have two oranges in here?
Yeah.
You're going to jail.
Yeah.
And we thought those stops in California were for fruit flies.
Is there like a school for oranges where you can get their certificate? You got an online course?
I got my certificate, honey, and transporting oranges.
Taking night school for my
at the school, they're grinding oranges, making orange juice, and they're peeling it with their fingers.
While
their
driving.
Their hands are all like red and sore from peeling orange after orange.
While transporting them?
How long did it take him? It was 11 truckloads?
Dude,
so he owns like 11 trucks, or did he like do one truckload, come back? Did he go at night?
How big were the trucks?
How big were the loads?
I got a lot of questions for this guy.
How big were the oranges?
Hey, yeah, that's true.
CW said there was another guy. Southall and another man were found by deputies Wednesday picking fruit at a Dundee Grove after the sheriff's officer's helicopter pilot saw them. It's unclear if he was retained an attorney. Deputies say that the two had picked more than four rows of sunburst tangerines. The port said they were preparing to load the fruit into South Hall's truck. So it might have been like a mini truck. Because 2,000 oranges would be like one dump truck, right?
Nah.
That's a lot of oranges.
I feel like it's just like the truck bed of maybe a small
Nissan. Datsun.
Yeah,
you remember those?
Geo Metro.
I do.
The little love trucks from the 80s?
Yeah.
Was that Nissan? I think Nissan did have the love truck.
The one that Dairy Boy had.
It's a little Nissan.
A little Nissan. That's what I'm thinking about, the truck bed size.
Have you ever seen a love truck? They're cool, dude. Like, if you like old cars, the love truck, dude, that's something that truck collectors or whatnot like. They're really cool. My friend had... See, there's the blue one? No, that's not it.
Like Love's? Like the gas station?
LOV truck, or maybe it's LUV truck. I don't know. You put Love's truck. There's gonna be a yeah. I see them. Aren't they cool?
Yeah, it's like a. It reminds me of like a farmer's truck.
But they're little bitty. They're like micro bitty. Trucks. Uh-huh. Yeah. My friend's dad had one of those like baby blue ones. Throw it up there for the listeners to look at.
Yeah, throw it up there, listeners. Whoopsh. Are you saying I'm whipped? Are you saying I'm whipped?
Are you putting it up there?
You're right. I'm not putting it up there. They can just die sad.
They can die wondering.
Just type in
they
love
can
truck.
Google
they
it.
They know it's a Google.
There you go. I'll be like, love truck. Here you freaking go.
Love truck.
Can't do everything for him. You guys got to cut the cord sometime.
The umbilical cord.
To your listeners.
As we speak, I'm posting the news stories so you guys can follow
also,
along.
Yeah. On a side note, yesterday was Veterans Day, and my dad was in the Air Force, so shout out to my father. Shout
Should
out
we
to
play the Star Spangled Banner?
Nah, it's okay.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
You want me sing,
we'll watch everybody walking by, stop and salute.
America.
Yeah, sing, dude.
The one.
God shed his grace on thee.
And I'm proud of being American.
But yeah,
no. No Neil Diamond ever in my life.
No, that's proud to be American isn't Neil Diamond. You're thinking of
they're coming
America.
To America. We're coming to America.
But
today.
I went to the. They had.
It reminds me of the Great Invasion.
They had the
1492.
They had the
Columbus.
Blah, blah, blah.
The world was never the same.
They had the flag at half.
Now we live in trailer homes on reservations.
I just muted Jeremy's mic. They had the flag at half staff yesterday, and David Bourne went and gave a speech and all that. It was pretty cool. But shout out to all the veterans.
Shout out
for you guys that make this country the way it is, protecting our freedom. So thank you to all you veterans out there.
Absolutely. Thank you so much for your service.
Ralph Andrew Craig at Sooner Vision. He was in the military. John Pike, military. Kenneth Pletz, Mr. Dave, all you guys listening, thank you so much for your service. Past, present, and future. Can't thank you guys enough. So, let me unmute Jerry's mic now. Hold on 1 second.
You had to put him on hold to unmute me.
Hold on 1 second. I gotta reach over there.
I was actually
unleashing the Kraken,
getting ready for our next segment, which we've never done before, and it's a great addition. So make sure all you listeners listen up and comment. Come on, man, get involved. Get involved.
Get involved.
Get involved.
So, yeah, Jeremy thought of this the idea the other day. We thought we might try it out, maybe add a little bit of new spunk to the This and That broadcast.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh, spunk. You salty girl. You janky. Ooh. Ooh.
Okay,
salty.
And I didn't have time because this. I literally is working on this
literally.
All the way up to
can't
the
even.
Beginning of the show.
Literally can't even.
I cannot.
Literally. Is it literally or literally?
All I know is literally.
Like it's literally used like every word and like every sentence.
Shout outs to our classmates.
Shout
outs
to sorority girls. Shout outs, yes. Oh, Shay.
Literally.
Shay.
Literally,
Shay.
Shay.
Literally. She's not listening, like literally.
Literally, she's not listening
like,
ever.
Totally. Like
literally.
She's probably at Starbucks right now.
Our teacher knows who Shay is. He's probably snickering when he plays us back. Well, speaking of, did you email him?
I did.
Awesome. You're on top of stuff. I guess we need some intro music.
Satan, lend me a dollar. Satan, lend me a dollar now.
All right, that's our trivia tune.
Wow, I love that.
All right. First one.
Okay, so we're going to write these down. We're not going to say that. We're not
going
to shout them.
Yeah, I want you guys to write them down, and then we'll... Then you can reveal the answers together. Let's see. That
don't
way
cheat.
You don't interrupt each other's.
All right.
Guess it. Ready? Our first one is... Wait a minute. Let's pop this up that way. Okay, listen.
I'm not a smart man, but I know what love is.
Hmm. Interesting. Very.
And these are going to be simple, but should we do this again, I'll get a little bit more complex.
I like your style.
You know, gotta get y'all, set the bar for you.
The first one's always the easiest.
That's okay, right. So that one. What did you write?
The deepest.
What did you write, Thug Life?
I wrote Forrest Gump.
All right, that's what that was.
Ding, ding, ding.
Jenny.
1 point each.
The score's tied. Next one.
When the master gives you something, you take it. He gave you a name. It's a nice name. It's Toby.
Kunta Kinte.
Now, what's your name? Kunta. Kinte. Kunta Kinte. All right, what'd you write?
I put Roots.
I was hoping that one of y'all would get that mixed up with like the color Purple or something.
Purple Rain.
Yeah. I put Jimmy Fallon in the Roots.
The Seed 2.0.
Okay, and I believe this is the one.
I'm funny how? I mean funny like I'm a clown, I amuse you.
Ooh, oh, what's
little Joe Pesci.
Oh, what's little it called? Joe Pesci. I forgot the name. Oh yeah, I remember now.
Okay, time's up. Just kidding. Mr. Time. Actually, what'd you put?
I put Goodfellas.
I put Goodfellas, yeah.
Goodfellas.
Oh, hello.
Goodfellas. I'm getting, it's getting intense now.
Okay, here we go.
Ready?
And this is for you younger guys. I couldn't get in this one, but here you go.
They've done studies, you know. 60% of the time, it works every time.
That doesn't make any sense. Yeah, well, that
can be Anchor.
Anchor Man. That's a great movie. If you haven't seen the first one, you're not an American. You're a communist. Don't bother watching the second one. It was a little bit of a disappointment.
This is another obvious one. So,
how many of these do we got?
We got 10 of them.
Okay.
So here's an obvious one.
I see dead people.
Wow. What's that movie called, though? Oh, shoot.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Oh, you cheater. You can't be doing that.
I would have got it.
That's minus point.
What? For giving him the score?
Yeah.
No. Maybe the sixth. It was the Sixth Sense. Yeah.
Sixth Sense.
You guys
Mambo
know?
Number That's 5.
Wait, Bruce Willis was a ghost? Wait,
what? I haven't seen
spoiler,
it.
Spoiler. Alert.
I haven't seen it.
No, but I already knew that was the
end. No,
ending.
You didn't. You don't lie. Don't you lie. Everybody. That's a minus point for you. It's tied again.
Yes.
All right, here's the next one.
They're here. Oh, I know that one. Oh.
Okay, spelling on here.
No, that does not count.
Okay, I didn't say it. I'm just trying to make somebody win, okay?
I think I'm going to take the lead right here.
I think you will, too.
You want to hear it again?
Play it again. Even though I already know the answer. It's actually sad that little girl actually passed away not too long after that movie. They're here. It is Poltergeist.
Nice, I did not get that.
I see dead people.
No, that's...
I didn't mean to do that. I almost went to the next one, so I had to go back one. Okay.
Yeah, I did not get that one. Never seen that movie, so...
It was Poltergeist.
Thank you, I Love the 80s Marathons.
All right. Here's another one. And I think King should get the... I don't know. You got to know your movies for this one. I mean, everybody's seen it.
Everyone?
I ate his liver with some fava beans and a nice Chianti.
I love fava beans.
I think I know.
And I love liver. Okay, what'd you write?
I put the Silence of the Lambs.
Yeah, okay. What was that number?
That'd be number 7.
So that means it is
we're on 8.
Keegan's got the lead.
I got the lead by 1.
6-7.
Kill him. Oh, kill him.
Ooh.
Ooh. Ooh.
Okay, here's one. And this is obvious.
No.
Come on.
Come on. Obvious.
Take your stinking paws off me, you damn dirty ape.
If you don't know that one.
Funny story, I'll tell you after the answer.
No, go ahead. I gotta set the. I wish it was easy as just pushing buttons, but it's not.
What is it, Thug Life?
Sons of the Apes.
Planets of the Apes, yep.
Did you say Sonnets of the Apes?
Sonnets? No, I said Planets. Sonnets.
Charlton Heston, Sonnets. Who was the voice of that character right there, in Greece, they had to change his name to Charlton Easton. Why? Because apparently in Greek, Heston means to poop oneself. So in all the poster boards, it'd be Charlton Easton. Because he couldn't say Heston.
Okay. Charlton would be pooping.
This is a real obvious one.
Is there not any obvious
ones?
Yeah,
the last one is going to be...
Impossible.
I'll be proud of you if you get it.
That they may take our lives, but they'll never take our freedom.
We know that one.
Yeah.
Do we even have to say it?
Yeah, you got to say
it's
it.
It's Braveheart. Brave Heezy.
For the point. For
Brave
the
Heezy.
Braveheart. So I get the point.
Yeah. Okay, here's the last one.
All right, let's do this.
I think this is the hardest one.
Ray, when someone asks you if you're a god, you say yes.
Yes. Play it one more time.
Oh, I know this one. I already got
Ray,
it.
Ray, when someone asks you if you're a god, you say
yes.
Got it.
I actually don't know this.
Come on for the tie.
Oh, goodness.
Come on.
I don't know. Wheel of Fortune?
That's Price is Right. No. So it's a tie then.
Ghostbusters.
Yep, Ghostbusters.
Oh, yeah.
That they defeat the thing.
If someone asks you if you're a god, you say yes.
Wow, there's a tie.
It was hard to find because there's a lot of good movie quotes that have cuss words in them.
That makes sense, too.
Touché. You're right.
But I got a whole list of them. I got 100.
That's a lot of fun. I think hopefully, listeners, tell us what you thought about that. We might do that a little bit more. Maybe we'll maybe do like a music segment or something cool.
That play at home, maybe.
Maybe we'll do like pop culture trivia where I can do like a riff from a song.
We should just get some Trivial Pursuit cards and just say them over the end there. This man was the first man on the moon.
You'll have to have play along at home so I can do it next week.
Yeah.
It's like, all right, we'll play them out.
Because you're doing a playbook on Wednesdays. You should just like playbook. Turn all on the computers and turn our show on to max capacity. Maximum capacity.
I'll hit 88 miles per hour.
What movie's that from?
Hackers.
Oh, Keegan, you didn't get it.
I didn't hear the quote.
Gets the win. Yeah. Thug Life.
Thug Life. He's killing him. Killing him, I tell you. Killing him.
I got a lot of free time. I watch a lot of movies.
See, I wasn't for sure. But that was kind of fun. It was a lot of work to clip those out, but
thank you for your hard work. I enjoyed it.
I know, it was fun.
And doing it for the Vine.
So what's next, guys? What are we doing here?
Maybe a little bit of music, what and then we will go home and rethink our lives.
What do we normally do? Is it beer of the week and then top 10? Do you got a top 10?
I don't know anything.
Okay,
we'll figure it out.
We'll come back. You're listening. Woo woo woo.
Hey, boo-boo, let's go get some picnic baskets.
You listen to This and That on The Wire, your student radio. Bring us back.
Yeah. Ooh. Yeah.
One yeah. more time.
This and that. Wednesday mornings, 9 to 11. On the wire.
I love that
radio.
That is for the listeners who want to know, because I got a couple messages after last week. That is Heard It Through the Grapevine by The Slits.
The Slits.
Yeah. They're like a modern day of Four Non Blondes.
I like that. That's good.
Okay. So,
Hey, where'd you go, man?
I'm right here.
No, I can't hear him.
Oh, he's what right
I
there.
Do? What'd I do? Did I break it?
Yeah. I think you're talking to the wrong side.
Oh. Yep, you're right. My bad.
Okay.
We at The Wire, next week we'll be partaking in a Toys for Tots marathon all day, November 20th and November 21st. We will be on remote as well in the studio. We'll be located at Hertz Donut on Campus Corner here in Norman. So if you have a chance on November 20th or 21st, no matter what time of day, it's 24/7, please donate your some toys to underprivileged children. So I'll be there sometime during that day. Jeremy will be there. Then we will alternate. We'll be in the studio. But everybody at The Wire will be working on this. So if you have a chance to come by, we'll be working day and night, airing on the show, delivering toys for underprivileged children. So if you could also bring two toys, because if we bring one, then we get a free donut.
I'll tell you what.
Not that that's the initiative or anything, but.
The third person I see drop, while I'm out there, drop in a toy, I will buy them a half a dozen of donuts. I feel philanthropic, man.
Yeah, you know, I think I'll do that too.
Give me half a dozen donut
holes.
So I can
get a donut if I just.
You got to wait for the third person, though.
Yeah, you got to be
I'm
going to
wait for
person.
The 20th person. The 20th person will get the. Yeah.
20 people going to reach
I need the 60th, 68th person. Yeah,
the 144th person I see in my hour.
On the 21st.
So make sure.
I'll be out there early in the morning, so
I'll be
anybody
up.
Out there.
Yeah.
I'm going to remind people who are there, hey, dude, third person I see drop in a gift. I want to at least get three gifts. That's what I'm setting my par.
I'm in the midnight to like 2 o'clock area between those 2 days. So,
really?
Yeah, I got the graveyard shift because I forgot to go to class last week. I totally forgot we had class.
You're gonna be chilling on the cold
we'll
in the nighttime.
We'll be chilling in the booth for about an
angry.
Hour.
He's gonna be angry.
We'll be chilling in the Hertz
get
donut.
Get away from me, Jeremy. I'm not in the mood.
A really good donut. Like a really good donut. A really good donut.
Donut.
What time is it, Jerry?
It's about that time.
Is it?
It's a time for beer. Oh, man. We don't have that.
Oh, man. That's right.
Spiritual Buzz.
Spiritual Buzz. We're so sorry.
We're working on getting a copy of that, but we like the recording goes straight to the little ditty you did, but it ended right as you started to strum.
We're going
to
figure it out, but I guess we can do our a cappella version real fast.
Yeah.
Ready? 1, 2, 3.
Beer of the week.
Beer, beer, beer of the week.
Beer, beer, beer
of the week.
Beer, beer of the week.
What's this week's beer of the week?
It was sent to us by a listener in Oklahoma City. Linda Melendez sent us a beer of the week, and it is more of a hard cider, but nonetheless, it has bubbles, and nonetheless, does it do the job. It's a Johnny Appleseed hard cider. It's a refreshingly sweet and intense new drink for life's adventures. The new hard cider is the best enjoyed on the rocks to reveal its perfect balance of sweetness and intensity with a crisp and refreshing apple bite.
Mm.
It was inspired by the legendary adventure and storyteller Johnny Appleseed. The hard cider was created for anyone with a story to tell. So make sure you drink your... apple cider and tell a story, I guess, is what they're trying to insinuate.
Yeah, I'm a fan of...
Have you ever had it?
I have not. I've had a Woodchuck, Angry Orchard, Strongbow.
Did you like Woodchuck?
They all taste the same to me.
No, it tastes kind of stale to me.
Maybe you just had
I've never had it.
No, I mean, like kind of like dusty. Like gritty, dusty.
I understand what you're saying.
Yeah. There was no like texture in it, but I don't know. My favorite still is Angry Orchard, but Johnny Appleseed, we'll go try you out and on our next show. We'll see what we say.
Yeah, for me, I mean, I've only been drinking for a little bit, but it seems that the ciders, they're kind of more brand new in the drinking world.
Yeah, absolutely, as far as bottled ciders go.
It's like Red's Apple Ale, you got Angry Orchard, and Strongbow's really good.
Well,
you
know, Angry Orchard had been around for a while under a Sam Adams cider.
Oh, right? I did not know that.
Yeah, then they branched off and became their own company. But the recipe hadn't changed. It's still crisp. I mean, it's still that's what I like about it. It's real crisp tasting. But those of you guys listening, wait.
Thug Life, do you have a favorite beer?
I do have a favorite beer.
Okay, well, put that on our Facebook page. We'll get to it 2 weeks from now.
Yeah, we'll see if that happens.
What is it? Just tell me.
in his ear.
Just whisper sweet
nothings. Yeah, whisper
in
his ear.
La fin du monde.
Oh, la fin du monde.
La fin du monde. Oui, oui. We're French. We like a French fries.
They're
pirates. We are French pirates.
That's the last time I tell you guys anything. My gosh, just getting berated.
What's your favorite food?
The pirate game.
La fin du monde. Oh, you like love it. Wait.
I'm not saying I drink a lot.
You can see all the people walking by now.
And they're all wondering.
Totally ignoring us.
Yeah.
Can they hear us out there?
They can hear us. Cool.
Should we make them louder? So
that's
they,
as far as it
goes. Wait, this lady's on the phone. Don't do that.
Hey, lady on the phone.
Hey, lady on the phone.
Hey, lady on the phone.
You.
Get off the phone.
Get off the phone and wave.
Wave at us.
Wave and we'll quit talking to you.
We see you. You're on the phone.
Is that the one finger wave?
Get off the phone. Yeah. Hey, do you not see us? We're talking right at you.
For all the people in the...
We're standing
in
up
the
now.
Union. We just want to remind you to go right across the little courtyard there and pick up your Safe Ride voucher. Because
right.
We can't talk about the beer week without talking about being responsible. Because it's not drinking shouldn't be about getting drunk. It should be about having a good time.
Exactly.
But the best way to do that is to, if you're an OU student, go take advantage of the programs that are out there for you. And one of them is the Safe Ride voucher program, which will give you a free ride home on a Thursday night, a Friday night, or a Saturday night from 10 to 3 a.m. You can use these vouchers with any of the taxi services here in Norman. So make sure you bring your student ID to verify your current OU student, and you'll receive a wallet size voucher for that current weekend. To stop by the Conoco wing of the Oklahoma Memorial Student Union. And it's located off the Union Courtyard in room 181, Monday through Friday, noon to 7 p.m., and pick up your Safe Ride vouchers because, you know, nobody can afford a DUI.
Yeah, and Jeremy's used it. It's a really good deal. Make sure when you use it, call about 45 minutes to an hour before you plan on leaving, or else you'll find yourself waiting and waiting and waiting because those guys are really busy.
Mm-hmm. Hey, you on the phone.
She is in her own world.
Go pick up your Safe Ride voucher.
I've been trying to like stare her down, but she just manages to avoid eye contact.
She likes the eyes on her.
Watch, just stare her down. Just stare
wait
down.
At her.
Just
everybody
stare
wait.
At. Just stare at her. She's not even like she's in her own. She's not even.
She knows we're waiting.
She knows
we're talking
she's
to
avoiding
her.
It's all right.
Come on,
it's okay.
Come on.
Go get your Safe Ride. Hey, go pick
get
mine
your
up.
Get your Safe Ride voucher
I'm doing
right
a radio
now.
Show.
I'm busy.
Yeah, I'm like literally on the phone.
She's
literally,
these guys in the booth are talking
like
to me. And I can't believe it.
Down.
Like literally.
Look at us.
Oh my God. OMG.
Hello.
Look at us.
There's people in the booth.
Wow. Come on.
I'm impressed.
Man, she is good.
I am impressed.
She doesn't even know we're talking about her.
She doesn't
even
not
know
have
she's
any
standing
interest
next to
the
window.
Doesn't even realize.
Zero
we're pointing
interest
at her
all.
Right now. Say, hey, people
Hello?
Walking by.
Hey,
people
turn that
by.
Camera around. Show people. Just pick it up and point it.
You got to change the camera.
Yeah, I am. After you point it. There we go. There she is.
There she is.
If you're
guys.
Looking,
if you're
there's
looking.
The lady.
She's
ignoring
us.
Wow.
She is totally ignoring us.
No, she went right.
Oh, I got her over here.
She's listening.
Oh, there she is.
Table.
Over there.
She's
Table.
Listening on the phone, really.
She's going.
She got,
where's she going?
She got the double,
come back.
She got the double ear cover, though. So we don't know.
The
Maybe
double
she's,
ear
oh,
cover.
Oh, man. What a.
She knows she's on
meanie.
The.
She's dip-setting. Dip-set.
Put the camera back. She don't deserve any airtime. Enough of that, lady. Make sure you pick up your OU Safe Ride voucher.
This guy's wearing basketball shorts. I'm impressed.
Dude, it is chilly out.
That is not...
Hey, well, if you actually think about it, you just need to be warm enough to go from the car to the classroom.
That's a very true statement. And like, guys, I've sweated a mini shirt because I dressed in too many layers and
exactly.
I got to the desired location, and it was
And most
hot.
Of the classrooms here, especially... you have any classes in Adam Hall?
No.
Oh,
I do
God.
Not.
It's either
Scorching
way too
there.
Hot or way too cold. Mm. During the summer, it's way too cold, and during the winter, it's way too hot. So you bundle up, you get to class, you've been walking in all these layers, and then you get there and you're just burning up.
Boom, sweat.
Yeah.
Sweat lodge status.
Yeah. What? Just staring people down. Jesus. Just make them just uncomfortable.
Okay.
You gotta go to sweat
okay,
lodges?
Let's do it.
I'm honestly, like, no one wants to look at us. Come back. Come back.
No. She's staring at me, but I mean,
she was like,
can we blame her?
Well, we're all standing now. We should start standing more on the show.
I like this. Like the last 30 minutes, everyone
sway.
Just stand up.
A little swaying left and right.
Just kind of get reconnect with the people who are walking
you
to
know,
class.
Because
kinda.
They obviously do not.
Something's going on distracting them. We need to.
They're like, these guys
something.
Are creeping us out.
Hey, maybe go pull the fire alarm.
Okay, I'll be right back.
Because it's getting hot in here.
So take off all your clothes. I am getting so hot.
I thought you were dropping the bass.
Just stare at us, people. We're not asking for much. Just stare at us. Yes, you right there, staring at us.
Nice,
yeah, there
nice.
We go.
Hello.
Lizzie.
Hey, you. Turn around.
Come on.
Hey.
Yeah. You, no. Oh. Where? No.
Wait.
No. What?
Hello.
Huh?
Where are you going?
Just staring her down.
Come this way.
No. Aw. Mm. This guy right here. Look at him. Look at him.
Hey.
Look at him.
Hey.
Hey.
Make sure you
hey, you.
Like the post.
Come on. Yeah, there you are. There
to
you
get
go.
Your shout out in.
There you go.
Shout
there
out
go.
I like your beanie.
Pink
is really cool.
This guy right here.
We got
this
one
guy,
mic.
This guy right up here.
You guys got it?
He's going. Where's he
how's
going?
It going?
He's going. Hey, man, how's it going?
How's it going?
Good yeah. momento. Por
he said something. I don't know.
He's probably talking bad stuff about us.
No, that wouldn't be very nice.
Well, this was a lot deflating than I thought it would be. I'm going to sit back down. I'm kind of sad.
I just stood up because I had a wedgie. You guys are looking at a lady. I'm over here plucking.
Ew.
Wow.
There's a little bit of this and that, I guess.
Yeah,
a little bit less of that, okay, Jeremy? More of this. When we come back.
Make sure if you are listening to us or not listening to us to download the TuneIn Radio app or go on tunein.com. Make sure to search your student radio. You will find the wire, our wire, because there's like 20 wires. Livestream.com/thewireou as well as wire.ou.edu or always you can listen. But if you go to wire.ou.edu, you can see our live television stream, and we will wave at you, I guess, figuratively, not literally. So make sure to, you know, help a brother out pretty much. So go on our Facebook page,
right,
like
right.
it. Did you like it?
I'm working on it.
You're working on liking it? I'm pretty
sure
you liked it.
I'm pretty sure I did too, but if I didn't, I'll go like it again.
So,
It's fine. Hey, let's go to a break and we'll come back with the top 10.
Okay, let me pick the song.
Go ahead, pick your song and not your butt. Where's the laugh, man? It was a joke.
I'll give it to you.
That is what she said.
You give me the chuckles.
Ready?
Yeah, you listen to this and that. On the wire.
Yeah.
You're freaking out, weren't you?
This and that.
You're like, they can hear the 360.
Wednesday mornings, 9 to 11. Yeah.
Hey, that
bars.
Was for, It was
bars.
For Dairy Boy.
Mm.
Bars.
Mm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was Arctic Monkeys.
Bars.
You guys
what?
Know you like it.
Looking.
Bars.
At people.
Getting it.
Walking.
Bars.
With their coffee.
Bars.
Standing.
Church.
Looking at people.
Preach.
Yeah.
Bars.
I'm white.
Bars.
Yeah.
Bars.
People. Look at us.
Stop getting.
Look at us.
You're breathing heavy.
Look at us.
Don't breathe out your mouth.
Some of these people are not dressed for this winter weather.
People don't know what weather is.
They're like, I'm from Alaska. It's not even cold.
This is not even anything. This is just, this is what you do on a normal day.
Well, as always, we have a top 10 list, and today's top 10 list is 2013's top 10 Christmas gifts for everyone on your list.
Ooh.
That was for 2013. Now, these by no means are in order of sales or anything. These were just great gifts that Quicken Loans, Zing by Quicken Loans, thought would be great in 2013. Some of them have changed, and probably a lot of them are same or just newer versions.
Yeah, from what it looks like, most of that is probably the case.
Yeah.
You want me to start it off?
Yeah, man, why not? Fire away.
So last year, number one was Breaking Bad box set.
Which was really good.
One of the most popular television series of the last few years and is certainly missed by fans everywhere. Let him relive the excitement with his complete box set. I only got to season three. I kind of quit watching it.
Yeah,
I got to episode one.
It just got slow.
It was just kind of, I mean, it's a great series.
You know, and I think that's it because, you know, season three of Weeds was like that.
Yeah.
Like, it just kind of was like, they were just throwing it's stuff at the wall to see what would stick. And then season four came along, and it was cool again.
Yeah.
But when it gets to season six, and it's just like, there's so much going on, you're just like, okay, we got to stop.
It makes you, like...
I just miss Agrestic.
At the same time...
When they left that place.
In the boxes.
When people...
little boxes.
When you have a really popular show like that, and you don't know how many seasons you're going to last, I mean...
Dude, eight was pretty good for Weeds.
Yeah.
They could have ended it better, but
could have ended it sooner.
Sometimes the shows with so many seasons, they really gotta make that next season even bigger and better and magicaler. Magicaler?
Magicaler.
Magicaler.
New word of the week. Magicaler.
This is something I actually might want. The Tarantino box set. This Blu-ray collection is the perfect gift for any Tarantino fan from Pulp Fiction to Django Unchained. This compilation will keep him entertained for hours. After hours. Yeah, I'm a big Quentin Tarantino fan. I like Reservoir Dogs is a good movie.
Yep.
You just became a Quentin Tarantino fan, didn't you?
Over the summer, I watched all his movies. Yeah. Except for Jackie Brown. I haven't seen that one.
You haven't seen Jackie Brown yet, huh?
No, that's
well,
on my list.
Well, that's your homework assignment. On Sunday, we will talk about that on our pre-record. Make sure you come out and join us.
Yeah, that's right. We're
this and that.
If you haven't heard, we're going to think about doing a pre-recorded show on Sunday.
The location is yet to be determined, although it probably will be in Norman. So come out and see us.
Yeah, and maybe we'll get you on.
Stay tuned.
Talk to us for a little bit.
Oh, yeah. Friday, we'll definitely let everybody know. So stay tuned Friday on our page.
Number three, The Man Can Candle. Candles have long been a thing for women, but not anymore. The Man Can combines rustic design with scents tailored for men, like and pizza, sawdust, and grass clippings.
And it's grass clippings. Shaped like boobs. I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. It's really not.
Rustic design.
Yeah. Number four, shaving kit. After No Shave November, he's going to be longing for one of these. The Art of Shaving offers some great sets in multiple scents to suit any guy's facial hair needs.
You know, I've never used shaving cream.
Really?
I don't like to. I don't like to do the clean shave.
Soap in the shower, man.
Really?
Yep. You know, sometimes just dry shave.
For me, when I have to shave, it's a big deal.
I imagine for you. Yeah, I got a sensitive face. I got a baby face, so I'm using all kinds of creams and lotions. Trying to keep
creams and
creams
sugar.
And lotions and creams.
Marmalades.
Marmalades. Number five, the NFL Super Bowl collection from Super Bowl I to Super Bowl 40s.
Is he gonna get this?
Is that that's okay? That was a five. That's a 40. 47. 46. 46. 46. Dang you, Roman numerals!
I guess this should be 47, right?
Should it?
The ultimate gift of any football fanatic. NFL Films has put together a complete collection of all the highlights in Super Bowl history.
Should have had like the whole
shoulda, woulda, coulda.
Yeah. The next one is good. Any year, I had one of these, but it was so good somebody took it. It grew legs and walked away.
The Leatherman Multi Tool. Leatherman's Sidekick Multi Tool is a fantastic gift for your handyman. With sleek styling attachments for just about everything, this tool is sure to be a hit. Yeah.
Get him.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Yeah. Number seven, an extended battery iPhone case.
was worse than having a dead phone when you're out of a night on the town. We've all been there, and it stinks. Ease his mind with this extended battery iPhone case. Oh, yeah.
Give me that battery, girl.
Yeah, girl.
Charge Tonight's me up.
The night we're going to get battery cases.
About to get fully charged.
You know
charged.
How I know? Because it's Wednesday. And Wednesday is the day we usually get battery cases.
Wednesday is usually the day we charge.
Tuesday is the night we visit your mother, but Wednesday is the night we get battery cases.
Wednesday is the night
Say,
I slip
me,
my
officer.
Dongle into your port.
But I'm fully charged.
Pardon me, sir. I didn't have my citrus license to move those citrus oranges.
You bring the brick, I'll bring the dongle.
Number 8, the iPad Mini. Certainly one of the most sought-after gifts this holiday season. The iPad Mini will make him the envy of his friends.
I don't really think that's true whenever you have friends like Nick.
Tech Talk with Nick Von Busch, the man that the Google advocating,
Apple
iOS hating guy. Do you hear that? Actually, this is something that he brought up to the other day. Apparently, he works at Radio Shack, our friend Nicholas, who you might have heard on our show talking about like tech savvy stuff from time to time. He was telling me that Radio Shack will be open on Thanksgiving Day from 8 a.m. till midnight.
Wow. That's messed up.
He's contemplating whether he's even going to work. He's like, he's at the point, he's like, that is not even fair.
Why?
It's messed up, man. Who's going to be shopping on
Thanksgiving Who's really day? Thankful anyways?
I am. Absurd. I'm thankful to have this guy and this guy in my show right now.
Yeah,
that's right. I said it my show. Jer, I said it.
I'm thankful for his show. I'm not.
No, I'm thankful for our show. I'm thankful for my friends and family.
Thankful for the veterans.
But at the same time, should anybody have to work on Thanksgiving? National
I don't know,
holiday.
It depends. I mean, you know, if you have blonde hair and blue eyes and you hate Apple. I'm just kidding.
And your last name is Von Busch.
He sounds like an evil villain, Von Busch.
Von Busch, we meet again, Von Busch.
Wow. We are French pirates.
French pirates.
We wee.
Von Busch Estates.
Even though I have a German last name, I have a French an accent.
It's Von Busch.
We go to number 9, the Pill Speaker from Beats by Dre.
The
welcome
Pill
to Pill Speaker.
Speaker.
Sure to be a welcome gift for
Beats
any
by
music
Dre.
Enthusiast.
Beats by, I think Beats is just
Beats by Dre.
Yeah, like as a consumer item, if you're gonna spend that much money, you might as well just go for Bose.
That's a good a good fantasy football team name is Beats by Ray.
But I'm
not
too soon
enough.
My fantasy football team
not soon enough.
My fantasy football team is Adrian Peterson switch hits. He's a switch hitter. So
I don't get it. What's that a takeoff of?
Well, switch hitter is somebody in baseball.
I know that, but
well, he got arrested for hitting his child with a switch.
Oh,
it
Ray
was
Rice.
It was a play on words.
No, this is Adrian Peterson. Ray Rice beat his girlfriend or wife. Well, I forget. Was it wife?
It was a fiance.
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 Punch her in the face. Punch her in my face. Face punch.
Nobody likes Pill Speakers anyways.
No. Number 10. Nike Fuel Brand. Messed that up.
Try it again. One, three.
Nike Fuel Band. One of the year's most anticipated fitness gadgets. The Nike Fuel Band is sure to be a wonderful workout companion for any man.
Yeah. When you said the pill speaker, I first thought it was like something that like told you about your pills. Like, this pill is for Monday.
Take two of these on Wednesday. Take one of these on Thursday.
Is that the new pill speaker? Yeah, it tells me how to take all my pills.
It's a little dwarf guy. Yeah. And he's
got a mini megaphone.
Hey.
He's got pills.
And he's got like a Brooklyn accent. Hey, take your pills.
Oh, you like
your
pills,
hey? Hey, take your
extra,
pills.
Extra, extra.
Why aren't you taking your hat? Pills? Hey.
Take your pills today.
You're crazy. You're crazy. You're supposed to be taking your aspirin. Your
pill
Valium.
Speaker is brought to you by pharmacists everywhere.
Where's your methamphetamines?
Speaking of Breaking Bad.
Women. 2013 gift guide. I'm going to blaze through these because I want to get to the next one, which is pretty cool. Portable phone charger, because we know you guys all are not good at
phones
holding
or charging.
Yeah, so
not good at charging.
Next one is Michael Kors watch. I've never heard of that one.
Michael. Yeah. Oh, that's that really fancy.
It's true.
Yeah, I just learned about this the other day. Thanks, Hunter, for
Next one was at home gel nail kit.
Huh?
I know. I never heard of that one.
Yeah, these aren't
gel
fun.
Or women. Like jail, like jailer.
for when you're locked up.
Yeah.
So you next one is girly apron, which I think if you got a woman an apron, she'd be mad. Like, what do you expect me to go cook you something?
Yeah, what con? What's
like no, because then I'd get you a stove.
Aren't most aprons girly?
No, I got one with the little baby from
Hangover.
Hangover, yeah. It's all, yeah, it's pretty neat.
I like
that. That's what I cook out with.
I like your style.
Personalized clutch. And as a guy, when I hear that, I think of like the clutch pedal in my car.
It's got like a cool,
yeah, it's all blinged out with little like rhinestones everywhere.
And like cheetah skin.
Yeah.
Purr, make your car go.
Knitting kit. Like, because you just know every woman knits right after they cook, right after they cook you dinner.
I just made you a sweater.
Yeah, who made this list?
I made this
exactly,
sweater.
Dude. This is a guy, man. It has to be. And then Seco design scarf.
Yes, because you got to keep your neck warm.
Just in case you couldn't knit your own.
Because,
scarf for you.
Because one button isn't good enough for them.
It's for the ladies with no arms.
They get the Kindle Fire HD because
yes.
Women don't like Apple products, no. Apparently.
They like to read
An
books.
iPad mini isn't good enough for them.
Books.
And then the mat.
The mat?
The mat.
Is it a yoga thing?
Probably. I was thinking cooking again.
Because every woman does yoga. Yeah, this does not sound like a very accurate list.
The next one's pretty cool, though. It's 2013 guide for teens and tweens.
Teens, tweens, and everything in between.
What does that even mean?
Beats by Dre headphones. Did
Beats by Dre stink.
I know, man. Whoa. Save your money, people.
Go buy some Sennheiser mics.
Because you're just a consumer. Don't worry about the professional end stuff because you wouldn't be able to appreciate it
anyways.
Go
get a cheap $10 pair of Sony headphones like Keegan, who got them on clearance when he worked at Target.
If you have Beats, you just have too much money.
If you have Beats, you're a communist, pretty
much. It's like they're too basic. Well, some people just like the base.
But they were a gift, so I don't appreciate these guys.
And if you get them for free, then, I mean, I'd sell them, buy some.
Yeah, I'd sell them, buy some drugs, support your habits.
You guys distract that guy, I might go over there and...
sell his drugs.
My mom just informed me we are going to Benvenuti's tomorrow.
Oh, Benvenuti's.
Ooh, I do.
For my Padre's birthday.
Tomorrow.
The next thing is a bath set. Teen girls doesn't love body spray and shower gels that smell like desserts.
What?
I don't know. What the?
You just have
what
a stroke?
The did you say? I don't know. Bath set. I guess that's good for guys and girls because... You know, sometimes they have, like...
I'll be digging on a nice bath, bubble bath every once in a while.
But think about it. Anytime somebody gives you a bath set, you think, like, do I stink? Is that why they're giving it to me?
My mom does it every day, so I guess I'm smelly. She says I look really grungy. I don't
Rechargeable speaker. Everybody needs one of these.
I think that looks good for you. I think it's a good look for you.
I actually just bought one of these.
What do you mean a rechargeable speaker?
You know, a little Bluetooth portable speaker?
Oh, yeah, the one you got in your car is pretty cool.
Yeah, dude, it is pretty nice.
Is it loud?
It's pretty cool.
It's cool. I got the little Braavin one, and if you set it on a wooden table, it really sounds whole much more, like, a whole lot different, dude.
Do you a little acoustics to it?
It's pretty neat, dude.
I always want one of those for, like, the evangelists to come out to, like, this near the corner. I mean, they come out to all the circles and start yelling at people and preaching, and I just want to have a big speaker. They go out there and just drown
them out. I like this one,
man. Or a megaphone.
Check out number four.
No.
Why can't we be friends?
I don't want to. You try out number four.
Wouldn't that be cool?
Well, I don't even know what number four is.
Couldn't you see that on your wall?
I can't see it. You're not showing it to me. Show it to me. Do it. Show it. Can't see it.
Do it. Do it.
Do it.
Go check it out on the Facebook page. Number five. P.S. I made this book. No Way Crafty Teen. This book is full of DIY projects. That's just to keep the kids busy and off the streets. You know, in Italy, what is it, Venice, where they have canals? Instead of saying, we got to keep the kids off the streets, they say, we have to keep the kids off the canals.
And in Italian, they say, I'm just kidding.
Bibbidi bobbidi boop.
Bibbidi
bobbidi.
Number six, Birchbox subscription.
I don't even know what these things
don't
are.
Don't know what that is.
I mean, I'm tired of all these subscription-based things. Like the shaving thing. And
yes.
Like, they even got one now for, like, geeks. Like, they send you, like, geeky toys every month for, like, $40 a month.
Stupid. Hey, man, I'm getting into this stuff. That's what I do. I got a scarf on right now.
No, that's cool having geeky stuff that you buy individually, but to subscribe to something just so you can stay geeky. It's like,
oh, yeah.
I paid my geek subscription this week.
It's making it easier for people who don't know how to be geeks, be geeks.
Freaks and
people
geeks.
People that are just too cool.
Too cool for
what a douche,
geekhood.
It makes it easy for us to look like you guys.
I'm just.
What do you mean by you guys?
I don't mean to rain on our parade. We only have 5 minutes left in our show.
I know, because you took so long with your list.
Yeah, you're taking so long with yours.
Anyways, go look at number four, people. That was really cool.
Don't look at number four, people. Don't listen to Jeremy.
Longboard.
Yeah.
Our kids got longboard.
That's something that Kolby
I skipped
would do.
Seven.
Kolby's a longboard guy.
And I went to eight. Longboard.
There's my real name, everybody.
Oh, who? What? Thug Life?
Yeah, get a longboard. It's fun.
It is fun.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Make sure you research them, though.
Kolby is a friend
really
of mine.
Cheesy
from
ones. Don't get none
Staten
at Walmart,
Island.
Man.
Yeah, do not get one at Walmart.
Ryan Gosling journal. Hey,
oh
girl.
Oh, my God, yes.
Wait, is that his journal?
I like your taste in Christmas.
Or is it a journal with Ryan
Gosling
on it? Oh,
shucks. Thanks, Ryan.
Both.
I'm blushing.
His own
hashtag
journal.
Hashtag blushing.
His own journal has his face on it.
Yeah.
With his deepest, darkest thoughts.
I got
and a Swiss Army knife because you know you want your kid arrested at school. That's our top 10 list for tweens and for men and women, but the women was confusing. We needed a girl here to justify some of those.
Yeah, that's
we
true.
Need to we do need our shout-outs. So far, I only see one shout-out.
Two. Shut up.
Daniel Robert Leon.
And who else?
And Jeremy Deere.
Shout-out to myself.
But I have to give shout-outs to...
To Thug Life.
Thug Life.
And your friend Kolby.
Thank yeah,
who
from
lives
Staten
in Jersey.
Island.
Oh, Staten Island.
Chase O'Hara always gets a...
Love you, Chase.
Shout-out because he keeps crying when I don't.
Love you.
Dr. Ken always gets a shout out because Dr. Ken is our most avid listener.
Dr. Ken, thank you for your service.
Thank you for your patronage
and thanks
your
for the
generosity.
Beard, keeping it up all these years.
Tell a little Gordy, he's a cool man. Little guy.
Shout out to Gordy, Gordash.
Gordon Bombay.
Gordon Levy.
Pletz.
Gordon Not Levy Pletz.
Shout outs to Mr. Dave. Thank you for your service.
Despite the fact you're always busy and you never listen, you don't even know that we have a show.
Yeah, you don't even know we exist.
Shout out to Braxton. Snodgrass. Braxton May.
Chris Turner. Shout out to Chris Turner. Oh. Braxton Snodgrass. Ooh. Chris Turner. Shout out to...
Beer.
Beer and...
Sonic Lizard.
Cocaine.
Whoa.
I'm just kidding.
Shout out to Jimi Hendrix.
Yes. Shout out to Bob Dylan.
Shout out to Lyra Lou. She's
shout
another faithful listener.
To Freedom.
Shout out to America.
Shout out to veterans.
Shout out to my parents.
Everywhere.
Shout out to the flag of
my younger brother. Megan Zucala, I know you're listening, Zucala.
Shout out to Dairy Boy.
Dairy Boy.
I know he's sitting there like, where's my shout out? You guys play Fallout Boy, but you won't give Dairy Boy a shout out.
Where's Opeth? Why don't you have any Opeth? Shout out to Nick Von Bush.
Nicholas.
You got any shout outs?
We'll get you yet, Von Bush.
Shout out to...
Angel
the
Burke.
Fam and to my dog Coda at home. I know you're missing me, girl.
Shout out to Eli Hull, Dad Addison.
Shout out
Jay Freezy,
to Amanda Dad Wolf. Addison. We didn't get you last week. Natalia Flores.
Shout out to Skip Lechner. Lechner, old man Lechner.
Lechner.
Shout
I'll
out
get
to
you yet, Lechner.
Our haters.
No, keep it
shout
hating.
Out to all the other awesome shows. And did you,
thanks
oh
for
man,
support.
I wonder if anybody listened to us yesterday. We had a quick little brief. It was really awesome. We dominated those foos.
So, make sure to tune in next week on this and that for our on remote location show.
Hey, wait, we still got more shout outs.
We
okay,
have we 1 minute, man.
Jesse Carino, Audra Elizabeth Yinney, Taylor Young, Kevin Brown with an E, Hunter Schwartz, Justin Cook, Timothy Luke Mueller, Riza Valero McCoy, Tina Roberts Mina, Speak Memory, Sandra Sawyer, Jackie Treco, Anise Jones Geiger, Jeremy Deere, Beer, Sonic Youth, Jimi Hendrix, Rob Zombie.
Shout out to everybody. Thanks for having me on the
show.
Shout out to
God.
Shout out to these two.
Ugly, thanks so much for coming on our show.
Shout out.
It was a pleasure.
To all those that make these happen.
And
all of these.
Anything out there.
Yeah, dude. And shout out to Lynn Franklin. Shout out to Zach Zapanik.
Shout out to our intro class.
The whole intro class.
Shout out to...
Literally.
Shout out to Swag.
Shout out to Intro.
Salty. Shout out to Baze.
Shout out to all the Basic Girls out there.
All the Basic Girls. Shout out to everybody in Benedictus College in Kansas. Shout out to everybody in California. Everybody in Alaska. Preach. Shout out to Joel that just walked by.
Joel.
Oh, 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 oh. Joe. All right. Well, we got to go now, apparently.
Yeah, that's time.
They're giving us the rap signal. I don't know who they are.
So thanks again.
They're playing us out.
Yeah.
Wednesday mornings, 9-11, this and that, on the wire, your student radio. Keegan, Mina, Jeremy Deere, Thug Life, in the house. See you guys next week.
You're listening to this and that on the wire.
I just said that.
Your student radio.